Thank you, Gordon. It's a privilege and honor for an organization that is less than 10 years old, CARTA, to partner with one that originated before the US Constitution was written. So the common theme supported by both organizations is the discovery and spread of factual knowledge. And time does not allow me to provide a description of the origins and goals of CARTA, but your program handout does provide a summary. So I will simply read our mission statement, which is to use all rational and ethical approaches to seek all verifiable facts from all relevant disciplines to explore and explain the origins of the human phenomenon while minimizing complex organizational structures and hierarchies and avoiding unnecessary procedural complexities. In the process, we want to train a new generation of scholars in anthropogeny, that is, understanding the origin of humans, and also raise awareness and understanding the study of human origins within the academic community and the public at large. So the overall question at hand today is, how are humans different from other great apes? At first glance, these last three words may appear a bit strange. Let me explain. We humans are, of course, primates who shared a common ancestor with old world monkeys, then with gibbons and other lesser apes, then with orangutans, followed by the gorilla, and eventually with the common ancestor, the chimpanzee and bonobo, so-called pygmy chimpanzee. So based on anatomical, physical, and behavioral features, we humans classified our closest evolutionary cousins as the great apes. But as this figure makes evident, we are more similar to chimpanzees and bonobos than they are to gorillas. In fact, we are more similar to chimpanzees than mice and rats are to each other at the genetic level. So from a genomic perspective, humans are just nothing more than another kind of great ape. And the correct term encompassing all these groups is hominid. So asking how we are different from the other hominids therefore represents one way to understand our own evolutionary origins, an approach that we call comparative anthropogeny. So carrying out this comparison requires attention to a very large body of knowledge. And one of the currently incomplete efforts of CARTA to collate this knowledge is at our website under the rubric of the Matrix of Comparative Anthropogeny, which is a collection of comparative information regarding humans and our closest evolutionary cousins with an emphasis on uniquely human features. MOCA is still very incomplete, but it's organized into domains, each grouping topics by areas of interest in scientific discipline, and some examples are shown here. Here's an example of a MOCA domain page, again very incomplete, with some listings of potential differences in just one area, physiology. So obviously today we cannot possibly cover all the possible differences between humans and apes, and we're just going to get a little selection and flavor for the differences that one can find. So in the time available today, we'll just focus our panelists to explore some specific examples of distinctly human features, ranging from genetic to cognitive to anatomical, to behavioral and biomedical, while also considering some implications for explaining human origins. So with that, let me hand over to the first speaker, Pascal Guignot.